Very funny guy from San Francisco. He's got a book out. He'll show it to you, I'm sure. It's called Vodka in the Limelight, The Story of a Bartender. Give it up for Yuri Kagan, everybody.
How we doing, everybody? Doing good? A little sparse here. It's okay. It's all right. Are we on a date?
No.
That's why we're sitting as far away from each other as possible. Okay, good, good. Definitely, no, we're not on a date. I don't care, so don't worry about it. How we doing? We're doing good? Doing good? I'm just getting started. I just have a lot of shit to complain about, a lot of shit. I perform all over the place. I perform at all sorts of clubs. And usually, wherever I perform, there's always some douchebag that has to go on stage and say something like, I'm 25, and recently I fucked an old chick. She's 35. Yeah.
Okay.
That doesn't even make sense. It's not old. No one gives a shit. Gay people, we don't talk like that. We don't ever talk like that. Like, if a gay person was ever to go on stage and use the same premise, it'd be something like this. It'd be like, man, I fucked this old dude. He was on life support. You guys don't even want to know how long it took for the blood to get to the right places. We had to wait for the paramedics. It was crazy. Like, that's how it would go. Okay, that's how you do it. You're welcome. You're welcome, right? I went to see the Book of Mormon yesterday. Have you guys seen this? It was good. It was interesting because when I went, there was a line of literally like 150 women in line for the bathroom. And all I could think was, this is what Bruce Jenner wants to dedicate the rest of his fucking life to? Waiting in line for the bathroom? Are you kidding me? I'm not even gonna start talking about how like women hate each other more than men. Are you kidding me? Like, a woman walks up to another woman, they're like, you look great! The second they walk away, bitch. Okay? Guys don't do that, we don't care. We don't care enough. Just feed us a burpose, we're fine. I was looking at Lady Gaga's Twitter feed on the way here, because I'm homosexual, that's what I was doing. And she called all her fans little monsters. You guys know this? She called all her fans little monsters. I call all my fans mom. It's pretty fair. I was talking to my mom on the phone recently, and we did a lot of small talk. Which it doesn't make sense to me. Like, it's weird that we call it small talk. It's a lot of talking for something that's supposed to be really small. Right? It's like 45 minutes, mom, stop telling me I need to get a better job, ask me how I am. Okay? And I was talking to her and I was telling her about my boyfriend. Let me just stop really quick. My boyfriend, his name is Richard Sherman. Shut the fuck up, I'm Anthony. Alright? Whenever I say that his name is Richard Sherman, no joke, it's just what it is, and there's always some asshole in the audience who has to be like, oh, you like the brother? If by brothers you mean a tall, skinny, white guy from Iowa, yes. Alright? Like, my boyfriend's so white that when he goes in the sun, he ignites. Alright? Like, he's whiter than the 99 cent store, okay? He's white. He's really clear he's white. So anyway, I was talking to my mom, and I was like, mom, so we just found out Rich has cataracts. True story. And my mom says, that's what you get for dating an older man. Who the fuck am I dating? Hugh Hefner? Like, really? Really? And my mom says, if you did, you wouldn't have any money problems. Let me explain something about my mom. My mom, as a kid, her logic was like this. She'd tell me things like, what was it? Marry for love, you're a fool. Marry for money, get a pool. Like, that's just how she thinks, okay? It's true, we're both in our 30s. My boyfriend has cataracts. Last year, I broke my hip. Don't ask. Like, next year, we're hoping we get a low-T commercial. Like, our life is pretty shitty. Rich is really nervous about getting cataract surgery. You know what you have any of you had it? You guys know what they do? They rip your cornea out, they give you a new one, okay? And he's freaked out, which is understandable. But he's a grown man that has jumped out of an airplane before for fun. Eye surgery scares him. Like, if you were like, hey, Rich, I have a dirty needle, let's give you a tattoo. I don't even know if it's clean, whatever. He'd be like, where? Let's go. If you're like, I have a plane to jump out of, let's go. But eye surgery scares the man. It's a bit ridiculous. He's so nervous about it. He's so freaked out about it. I was like, I know. We'll go to ocean. You'll feel better, right? Whenever you go to the beach, it's a weird mix of like pee and sand and musk that just smells great, right? You feel great. And he was relaxed and it was wonderful. And the thing is, I live in San Francisco, okay? And so I took him to the ocean, and the thing is, at least I told him I took him to the ocean. I drove him through the Tenderloin, passed by this guy that was urinating. I said it was a waterfall. He has cataracts, he can't see it. And I'm afraid he's gonna have surgery too soon because he'll see what I look like at all times, right? It's not great, it's not great. And before we go to bed, I don't know what your man does before you go to bed. Most men ask you for sex, right? They give you that healthy tap, they ask you for some sex. Like my man, he doesn't do that. He asked me if I did the dishes, right? And I was like, yeah, of course I did. And I'm afraid he's going to get a surgery too soon because he'll see, I haven't done a single fucking dish in a year. Like he's going to meet the weird raccoon that now lives in our kitchen. It's going to be very awkward, all right? It's going to be very awkward. And the thing is, so the way we found out about his eyes, the true story is, he went to lens crafters. Anyone here go there? Really? Two people in here that don't have insurance. Lens, him and me. Okay, you guys don't go to lens crafters, go fuck yourselves, all right? He went to lens crafters, and he went there maybe four or five times over a few months, and he's like, hey guys, my prescription seems wrong. You guys need to fix this, like, please. And the doctor was like, hey, you're fine, don't worry about it. I went to college in this mall, you're fine. You're okay. And then he went to a specialist, and the specialist was like, hey man, you have cataracts, fix your life. Alright? It was pretty fucked up. When we found this out, I was like, don't you want to go down to lens crafters and yell at someone, beat someone up, cuss them out? Like, this is fucked up. They got it wrong. And this is how you know we've lived in the Bay Area too long. Right? This is what Rich said. He was like, I'm going to do even better. I'm going to write a scathing review on Yelp. So I'm dating a pussy, that's what I'm saying. Which, my dad would be really happy because it's as close to a pussy as I'm ever gonna get, right? And truth be told, he got the surgery actually 2 weeks ago, it's true. And it's interesting because like, before they do the surgery, they ask, they go, what kind of lens do you want? What kind of lens does he want? He wants one that he can see out of. Fix his fucking eye. Like, what's wrong with you? And then she was like, no, but you get different choices. I was like, if you get different choices, pick one that's covered in fucking gold. Are you kidding me? Like, we have choices of what kind of lenses we can pick. And get this, not a single one of them has Wi-Fi. Like, really, we have all this technology. He should get a really cool eye. Like, imagine if Apple went into the business of giving you new corneas. So it would be the Apple II. It'd be pretty fucking amazing. I'd never get my man off the phone, all right? He's always on the fucking phone. It's no joke, this is my life. So don't worry about it. We're doing good. Anyone smoke weed? One person? Really? One person? I'm just trying to be relatable, all right? I smoke my weed a little differently than most people. I do it while I'm watching my favorite show, Intervention. Do you do that? No. It's true. Like, that's pretty much how I spent my holidays. Like, the way I spent my holidays was, it was 8 days of being lit at our house, right? Just a lot of weed. And I'm telling you about the holidays for this reason is, I spent my holidays, I didn't get a single gift. I didn't get anything from my mom, I didn't get anything from my boyfriend. I didn't get anything, and I didn't give a shit because it was so high, I didn't care, right? I didn't get anything, and then about a week ago, I got this package in the mail, and I was in the middle of smoking a shitload of weed, so I didn't. I got this package, I was starving, I thought it was a cake, you know? I opened it up, and inside was a little tiny vial of eye cream with a letter attached that read, "Dear Yuri, I hope to live to see day you look as good as me. $20 for your facelift fun. Love, Babalina." That's my grandma, okay? She signed it, but it was her full name. Like, I have two grandmothers that are alive in the entire world. She thinks I'm gonna confuse her for one of the dead bitches. Like, really. And as a kid, I wasn't even allowed to call her grandma. I used to have to call her my mother's younger sister. All right, let me just, like, I don't know if this makes a picture. Like, she's the type of woman, she's had her face lifted so many times her forehead starts at her neckline. You know what I mean? Like, she has so many parts of her body that my grandfather was considered a pedophile in 4 states. Okay? Alright? Like, my grandmother is the only person in the world that in her will, she has a stipulation that she needs to have a quote-unquote petite coffin. Alright, that's just the type of woman she is, but she tells the best stories. She also dyes her hair to match her dresses. Like, she's just one of those ladies, right? She tells the best stories. She has a story about everyone's birth in her family, and it usually goes like this.
Yuri, I remember this old baby in family. I remember this first daughter, beautiful day, sunshine, beautiful, beautiful baby girl. Yuri, I remember the day your mother born, beautiful day, sunshine. Your mother was big, big baby. We saw she didn't born, she was big, big baby. Beautiful day, I remember the day you born, Yuri, beautiful day. Sun shining, your mother said she look okay. And me, Yuri, I was gorgeous, gorgeous, Yuri. And you, Yuri, you was ugly, ugly baby. You was ugly, ugly, Yuri, you're so ugly. And on this day, grandma, you're like, grandma needs Facebook.
True fucking story, all right? Like, at most kids, when they play doctor, they show their wieners and shit, right? When I was a kid, I'd pull my face back and say I was waiting for an anesthesiologist. Role models, okay? And my mom would be like, don't pull your face, it'll stay that way, whatever. And I'd respond, oh, wait for grandma. Really? Are you guys really from Uzbekistan? No? Fucking liars. I could tell by your accent, because they speak English too well. People in Uzbekistan also speak Russian. I'm Russian. Anyone here Russian? Don't brag about it. No one wants to be Russian. Whenever I say that I'm Russian, most people don't believe it because, first off, I wear deodorant. Second, because you can't wear a tracksuit at all times. It confuses people, okay? I'll tell you about this. Whenever I say that I'm Russian, there's always someone in the audience that has to be like, Yuri, you're Russian? I'm Russian too, 5 generations back on my grandfather's side, once removed, 8 Bolsheviks. That's stupid, right? You're not Russian if you don't have parents that blatantly scare people. You're not Russian if you don't have an uncle that no one knows what the fuck he does for a living. You're not Russian if you have family that actually smiles in photos. You're not Russian if you don't have a grandmother who once she left Anne Frank's house said, well, at least they had room. You're not Russian if you didn't have this experience. As a kid, I was afraid of monsters. I'd tell my grandmother and she'd say,
Yuri, no monsters, mama. Only people who take away people you love in the middle of night. For 20 years, you stick alive in jail, dies that day, you never see papa again. Good night, mama.
True story. That's a little funny they give credit for, but whatever. That's my time. I'm just going to tell you one thing. I wrote a book. Check it out if you feel sorry for me. It's for free on Amazon today, or if you want to buy an actual book from me, feel free. It's like $3,000. So I have a couple with me at vodkaandlimelight.com. It's free just today online. But the rest of the time, it's like $3 million. So feel free. Log on, tell your friends. My name's Yuri Kagan. Thank you.